You're kind of a force of nature, aren't you?
When I need to be.
It's impressive.
You flatter me.
I'm trying.
Did I do the right thing? What I have set in motion here could destroy everything I have revered my whole life. One day they may write about me as a traitor, a madwoman, a fool, and they may be right.
What does your faith tell you?
I believe you are innocent. I believe more is going on here than we can see. And I believe no one else cares to do anything about it. They will stand in the fire and complain that it is hot. But is this the Maker's will? I can only guess.
What's going to happen now?
Now, we deal with the Chantry's panic over you before they do even more harm. Then we close the breach. We are the only ones who can. After that, we find out who is responsible for this chaos, and we end them. And if there are consequences to be paid for what I have done, I pay them. I only pray the price is not too high.
You didn't have any choice.
Didn't I? My trainers always said, Cassandra, you are too brash. You must think before you act. I see what must be done, and I do it. I see no point in running around in circles like a dog chasing its tail. But I misjudged you in the beginning, did I not? I thought the answer was before me, clear as day. I cannot afford to be so careless again.
Can't say I'm not grateful to hear that.
I can be harsh, I know. You've said you don't believe you're chosen. Does that mean you also don't believe in the Maker?
I can't really say.
I suppose it doesn't matter now. I have to believe we were put on this path for a reason, even if you do not. Now it simply remains to see where it leads us. It occurs to me I don't actually know much about you.
What do you want to know?
I'm not sure. Where are you from?
I thought you knew that.
I suppose I could ask Liliana. She has collected a frightening amount of information on you. But I don't want to ask her. I want to hear it from you.
The Circle of Magi at Ostwick. At least until the rebellion began.
Yes, I suppose that would have required you to stay on the move. Tell me, do you consider the Free March as your home? Are you eager to go back?
Wherever I am is home enough for me.
That's how I feel now, after years of tending to business for the Divine.
I'd like to get to know you better.
You would?
Is that a problem?
Not entirely. I'm just curious as to your motivation.
Is there any harm in us becoming a little closer?
Plenty.
Is that right?
As you wish. My name is Cassandra Pentaghast, daughter of the Royal House of Navarra, 78th in line for the Navarran throne. I joined the Seekers of Truth as a young woman, and was with the Order until they withdrew from the Chantry. I remained as the Divine's right hand, carrying out her order to form the Inquisition. And here we are. That's all there is to know, my lord.
You're a member of Navarra's royal family.
The Pentaghasts are a very large clan. Half of Cumberland could say the same.
Really?
No, but it feels that way. I have hundreds of relatives so distant they need charts to prove we're related at all. And they have them. Oh, yes. The Pentaghasts value their precious blood like it runs with gold.
They're not on very good terms with your family, then.
I do not visit, if that's what you mean. The Pentaghasts are famed for dragon hunting, but few actually pursue the craft. Most are fat and lazy. They pay lip service to the Maker and care only for idle pleasures and past glories. My brother was all that kept me in Navarra. Once he was gone, so was I.
Tell me about your brother.
I would prefer not to speak of Anthony. Another time, perhaps.
You don't seem to like your homeland much.
My family polluted it for me. What little I saw of my homeland was through the bars of a gilded cage. My uncle treated me like a porcelain doll to be placed on a shelf and dusted only when necessary. Thus, I did not see Nevara, the real Nevara, until much later. By then, I realized I knew it not at all.
Your uncle? What about your parents?
They had the misfortune of taking the wrong side in the second attempt to overthrow King Marcus. The king executed them, but spared my brother and I since we were family and children at the time. Thus, we were raised by my uncle, a mortal Etasi who preferred the company of his corpses to the living.
Your uncle was a mortal Etasi?
A death mage. He still is. My countrymen do not burn the dead. They bury them in special crypts. The mortal Etasi supervise the crypts, like priests. Uncle Vestalus oversees the grand necropolis. Nevarans spend more time honoring dead relatives than they do with living ones. It is odd to be so fascinated with death and its trappings. I will never understand it.
So you were the right hand to the Divine?
To Divine Justinia, yes. And Divine Beatrix before her, in fact. The position is normally reserved for Templars of the Knights Divine, but my circumstances were unusual.
Unusual how?
You don't know the story? Thank the Maker. I will tell you if you wish, but it isn't as exciting as some drum it up to be. The short version is that I once saved the previous Divine's life. My reward was becoming her right hand.
But what does a right hand do exactly?
What is your hand capable of? It gives, it takes, it beckons, it makes a fist. Liliana and I extended the Divine's reach beyond the Grand Cathedral. We went where she could not. After Beatrix, I was tired of the position and wanted to return to the Seekers. But Justinia convinced me to stay. Her vision for the future gave me hope.
You thought she could really change things?
Justinia knew the war was coming long before it began. She tried to avert it, but the forces arrayed against her were too strong. Sometimes you have to break a bone so it can be reset. That's where the Inquisition comes in. It was to be the answer. A means to preserve as well as an agent for change. I only wish she had lived to see it.
So what's the story about you becoming the right hand?
Sweet Andraste, do you really want to hear that? It was, what, 18, 20 years ago? Some still discuss it like it happened yesterday. The tale gets bigger each time it's told. I barely recognize myself within it now.
I'm sure you're just being modest.
I was there. I think I know what happened. To hear others tell it, I alone saved Divine Beatrix from a horde of dragons sent to assault the Grand Cathedral. Rather impressive for such a young seeker, wouldn't you say?
And the truth is?
I stumbled upon a conspiracy to kill Beatrix. A Templar Knight Commander was at its heart. And there was a dragon battle at the Grand Cathedral, but I had help from loyal mages who rallied to the cause. They freed the dragons from magical control. Without them, the Divine and I would both have died. Yet I became the right hand, and they are forgotten.
What happened to the mages that helped you?
They went back to their circles, with rewards and privileges and most holy gratitude. Many of them died at the conclave.
You're delightful, you know that?
No, I do not know that.
Mm-hmm.
I object. There is nothing delightful about me.
I beg to differ.
I think I preferred you in the stocks.
I'll let you get back to work.
Yes?
Can you tell me more about the Seekers?
The Seekers of Truth were born from the original Inquisition long ago, when it united with the Chantry. Seekers stood above the Templars, watching over them, but also investigating magical events they couldn't handle. We were meant to be incorruptible, above reproach. How seldom does reality match the ideal?
But what are Seekers exactly?
Those who know anything of us think we are Templars. We do not use Lyrium, however. Our abilities are different, as was our original purpose. We disciplined the Templars and were accountable only to the Divine. And not even her, truthfully.
So the Seekers commanded the Templars?
No. The Order didn't assume command until after the Rebellion. The Templars have always feared us. When a Seeker arrived at a circle, they knew trouble was afoot. That kind of power is troubling. You begin to think you are the only one who can solve the world's problems. If you don't see a problem, it doesn't exist. If someone insists it does, they are the blind ones.
Do you think that kind of problem could ever be fixed?
Possibly. Though the Seekers themselves would need to change. They were clearly not willing to, even though they abandoned everything they stood for to avoid it. In my heart, I believe they can still be salvaged. But not by their own hands.
How does someone become a Seeker?
Most Seekers begin training in their youth. I was much older, an exception due to my noble birth. We train rigorously for years. Our bodies and minds must be elastic to undergo the vigil, and most fail even then.
Is the vigil some kind of initiation?
It is the rite every Seeker must go through in order to summon their gifts. A full year of fasting, prayer, and separation from all distractions, including other people. We empty ourselves of all emotion, focusing only on the purity of our devotion. And the moment it finally ends, it's wonderful. Faith realized. I cannot put it into words.
I wish I could experience that.
If the vigil was not so arduous, I'd say more should attempt it. What if mages never needed to fear possession by demons? I'm told it is impossible, however. I suppose I'll never know the truth of it now.
Why did your order turn against the Chantry?
We originally united with the Chantry through a treaty that stated they would keep mages under control. It was felt Most Holy had tacitly allowed the Circle of Magi to vote on its independence, thus breaking the treaty. The Seekers saw themselves as justified, and they led the Templars into a war of righteousness.
You sound like you disagree.
We knew what was happening at Kirkwall, where the Mage Rebellion began. We looked into reports of Knight Commander Meredith's harsh treatment of her charges years earlier. But we found so many shocking cases of magical corruption, it was decided her actions were justified. If we'd been there when it happened, if we'd looked harder at the root causes.
You seem to care a great deal about it.
Too much, if you ask the rest of my order. When faced with a problem, the Seekers would close ranks and crush it. We would find an answer, but only once we felt we weren't being coerced. The moment the mages voted for independence, our response was predictable. It was difficult to watch.
You mentioned that Seekers have different abilities than Templars.
Entirely. A Templar's abilities come from Lyrium and are designed to hunt mages. Ours come from ritual and many years of dedicated training. We cannot be possessed by demons and are immune to mind control. Useful, considering our role. Seekers can gain other gifts, though that depends on the individual.
What kind of gifts do you have?
I can set the Lyrium within a person's blood aflame. Both mages and Templars bend before my will. Some Seekers use it to interrogate, others simply to paralyze. Once there was a Seeker who could use it to kill. That particular gift is considered rare.
I've no more questions.
Do you need something?
May I ask you about the Chantry?
It is difficult to say what becomes of the Chantry now. They have no Templars, no leadership, and no one left who is worthy of succeeding the Divine. It has fallen apart when everyone needs it the most. I ache to think what this will mean in the days to come.
Do you really believe the Chantry is worth preserving?
If you ask my opinion, it is. Absolutely. Cast the Chantry aside and new problems replace old ones. We will have learned nothing from history. The people need stability, and the Chantry needs a new purpose. On Drast, they had a dream for us. It can still be achieved.
So what should that new purpose be?
A dedication to what is truly important. Instead of building cathedrals and sewing gowns for the divine, the Chantry used to spend its coin feeding the poor. If we are to spread the Maker's word across the world, we must do so with open hearts and open hands.
That sounds rather idealistic of you.
Does it? I do not think it's so unachievable. The Chantry has many good, honest people. They just need direction and inspiration. They need to be freed from centuries of adherence to tradition and ceremony. A chance for renewal is at our fingertips. It does not have to come with utter chaos.
I'm surprised you rebelled against the Chantry.
I left my own order when they took the wrong path. It is no different. But in neither case did I stop caring. Indeed, I care so much that I feel drastic action is necessary. I suppose history shall one day judge my actions.
Will the Chantry replace Divine Justinian?
They will try. Once the priests withdraw for the Grand Consensus, it is against Chantry law for them to emerge without naming a new divine. Sometimes it takes days, or weeks, or even months. The problem now is that no clear successor to Justinia exists. All worthy clerics died with her at the conclave.
So what happens if they can't agree on someone?
Theoretically, they will argue until exhaustion takes them or they see reason. Practically, however, if the Grand Consensus goes on too long, the Chantry will crumble. Any cleric with ambition but little sense will see this as her one chance, and plenty of such clerics exist. We shall see what happens. The Inquisition must act in the meantime.
If they do choose a new divine, will you serve her?
That depends on whether she would have me. I am a rebel now, remember? And even if she would, I do not know. It would depend on what type of divine she is. I am no longer in a position to follow blindly, and no new divine could expect such obedience now.
What influence does Chancellor Roderick really wield?
He's a bureaucrat, responsible for communicating the divine's will to the rest of the Chantry. Therefore, he's accustomed to the clerics hanging on his every word, hoping his influence will benefit them. Despite that, Roderick is not a bad man. He's frightened, and believes his place is to fill the gap left by Most Holy's death. Some might agree. As far down the chain of command as he is, there is no one left above him.
How big a problem could he be?
No more than he is already. He sent his message to the College of Clerics. That is the only card he had to play. Dealing with him further only lends him credibility he doesn't deserve.
Thank you.
And what are we supposed to do, exactly?
What you always do, complain.
We've already spoken with Commander Cullen. No one listens. We want better quarters. We want the Templars kept at a distance. And some respect for...
This is not the Circle. You mages are our allies, not our wards. Act like it.
How are we supposed to...
deal with it? It never ends, evidently.
Is there an issue with the mages? Can I help?
The mages are here as equals. They need to get used to what that means. It is your doing, after all. You created this alliance.
Well, I hope it works. What other choice do we have?
Oh. I do sound like I'm blaming you, don't I? I don't disapprove. In fact, you did well. You made a decision when it needed to be made. And here we are. I wish I could say this was my doing.
You're flattering me.
I'm not. This always happens. Nobody ever takes my meaning.
You should see your face.
I'm thinking less flattering things now. Let's hope the breach has your sense of humor. You knew where Hawk was all along.
You're damned right I did.
You conniving little shit.
You kidnapped me. You interrogated me. What did you expect?
Hey, enough.
You're taking his side?
I said enough.
We needed someone to lead this Inquisition. Hawk was our only hope. He was the champion of Kirkwall. The mages respected him. And you kept him from us.
The Inquisition has a leader.
Hawk would have been at the Conclave if anyone could have saved Most Holy.
You can't change the past, Cassandra.
So I must accept what? That the Maker wanted all this to happen? That he... Varric is a liar, Inquisitor. A snake. Even after the Conclave, when we needed Hawk most, Varric kept him secret.
He's with us now. We're on the same side.
We all know whose side you're on, Varric. It will never be the Inquisition's.
Attacking him now won't help us, Cassandra.
Ha! Exactly.
And you better not be keeping anything else from us.
I understand.
I must not think of what could have been. We have so much at stake. Go, Varric. Just go.
You know what I think? If Hawk had been at the temple, he'd be dead too. You people have done enough to him.
I believed him. He spun his story for me, and I swallowed it. If I'd just explained what was at stake, if I'd just made him understand. But I didn't, did I? I didn't explain why we needed Hawk. I'm such a fool.
Good thing I still like you.
I'm serious.
You think I'm not?
I want you to know, I have no regrets. Maybe if we'd found Hawk, the Maker wouldn't have needed to send you. But he did. You're not what I'd pictured. But if I've learned anything, it's that I know less than nothing. I can keep staring at this, but I won't get any closer.
Something I can help you with?
Yes. Possibly. We saw so many Red Templars at the assault on Haven. Perhaps all that was left of the Order. What we didn't see was Lord Seeker Lucius. Indeed, I've seen no hint of any Seekers amongst the Red Templars, or anywhere. I have a growing suspicion Corypheus has imprisoned them.
Why imprisoned? He could just as easily have killed them.
Not easily. But yes, they may be dead. But the Seekers began this war against the mages. They cannot have simply vanished. There must be a trail we can follow, yet so far I have only discovered hints.
But they could have ended up just like the Red Templars.
Seekers do not use Lyrium. I assume Corypheus gained control of the Templars by corrupting the Lyrium they were already taking. To do the same to a Seeker, you'd have to force the Lyrium upon him. That may be what happened, but it couldn't have begun that way. We're missing a piece of the puzzle, Inquisitor. I need to find it.
Finding them obviously means a lot to you.
I left the Order, but I can never abandon them. I cannot even claim that rescuing them would be beneficial. They wouldn't look kindly on the Inquisition. But even so, if there's a chance... If we can spare resources to follow up on these leads, Inquisitor, I would appreciate it. Care Oswin. Odd that the trail should lead us here. Ban Loren is a pious, unassuming man. What has he become involved in?
He's involved in crazy. Just like everyone else these days.
Truer words have never been spoken. Let's see what lies within. Promises. I should have known. The Order of Fiery Promise is a cult with strange beliefs about the Seekers. They've hounded us for centuries.
What kind of strange beliefs?
They believe they are Seekers, the only rightful ones. They say we robbed their powers long ago, preventing them from ending the world.
Ending the world?
The only way to truly eradicate evil in their eyes. The world will be reborn a paradise. It's all nonsense.
Why haven't the Seekers dealt with them?
We have, many times. They simply reappear after a time like weeds. Nobody knows how.
Cultists? Why am I not surprised?
This explains why the Seekers might be here, but not the connection to Corypheus. As the Seekers of Truth have proven resistant to the effects of Red Lyrium, the Elder One has seen fit to place them in your care. Reclaim your destiny, and know that the Elder One expects your devotion as repayment. Signed by Lord Samson, Commander of the Red Templars. Does Corypheus not realize the promises want the world to end? What use are they to him?
So Corypheus sold the Seekers to these cultists?
And they leapt at the chance, of course. But this doesn't explain how he captured the Seekers in the first place, or what's been done with them. We must keep looking.
The letter said Seekers were resistant to Red Lyrium.
Our abilities grant us many gifts, but a resistance to Red Lyrium's corruption? That seems strange. Although it would explain why none have numbered among the Red Templars. And thus Seekers would be useless to Corypheus. He would have no leash to hold us.
We'll find them, Cassandra.
I know we will. One way or another. Daniel! Daniel! Can you hear me?
Cassandra! It is you. You're alive.
As are you. I'm so glad I found you.
No, they... put a demon inside me. It's tearing me up.
What? You can't be possessed. That's impossible.
I'm not possessed. They fed me things. I can feel it growing.
Can we do anything?
I don't know. This thing inside him.
The Lord Seeker. You have to find him.
Of course we'll find him. If he lives, we'll...
Lucius betrayed us, Cassandra. He sent us here, one by one. An important mission, he said. Lies! He was here with them all along. He's still working with them.
But we met Lord Seeker Lucius in Valroyo. He couldn't have been here.
That wasn't him. It was a demon, masquerading.
What? How could that be?
The Lord Seeker allowed it. He let the demon take command while he...
came here.
Cassandra.
Now is not the time for sympathy.
Wait. Don't leave me like this, please.
You should have come with me. You didn't believe in the war any more than I did.
You know me. I wanted that promotion.
Go to the Maker's side, Daniel. You will be welcome. He was my apprentice. I have never known a finer young man. Now we find Lord Seeker Lucius. Lord Seeker Lucius.
Cassandra, with a man I can only assume is the new Inquisitor.
And you're the man who betrayed his own order.
I presume you know we Seekers of Truth were once the original Inquisition. Oh yes. We fought to restore order in a time of madness long ago, as you do now. And we became proud. We sought to remake the world, to make it better. But what did we create? The Chantry, the Circles of Magi, a war that will see no end.
And aiding Corypheus is supposed to help.
Corypheus is a monster with limited ambition.
And your ambition is so much greater.
We Seekers are abominations, Cassandra. We created a decaying world and fought to preserve it even as it crumbled. We had to be stopped. You don't believe me? See for yourself. The secrets of our order passed to me after the former Lord Seeker was slain. The war with the mages had already begun, but it was not too late for me to do the right thing.
He's completely mad, isn't he?
Lord Seeker, what you've done...
I know. What Corypheus did with the Templars does not matter. I have seen the future. I have created a new order to replace the old. The world will end so we can start anew. A pure beginning. Join us, Cassandra. It is the Maker's will.
He was insane. He had to be. The influence of Corypheus, perhaps? Was he trying to disable the Seekers?
All these wasted lives.
He could not have destroyed all of us. I won't accept it. Let us return to Skyhold. I wish to see what's in this Book of Secrets. This tome has passed from Lord Seeker to Lord Seeker since the time of the old Inquisition. And now it falls to me.
That's a lot of not very exciting reading, apparently.
On the contrary, it's a delight. I'm riveted.
Oh, you're joking.
I assume you know about the Rite of Tranquility. The last resort used on mages in the Circle, leaving them unable to cast, but depriving them of dreams and all emotion. It should only be used on those who cannot control their abilities, but that has not always been the case.
Does the book say it was used for other things?
No. As a Seeker, I looked into... abuses. Mages made Tranquil as punishment. What finally began the Mage Rebellion was the discovery the Rite of Tranquility could be reversed. The Lord Seeker at the time covered it up, harshly. There were deaths. It was dangerous knowledge, the shock of its discovery in addition to what happened in Kirkwall. But it appears we've always known how to reverse the Rite, from the beginning.
That doesn't surprise me at all.
We created the Rite of Tranquility. I told you of my vigil, The months I spent emptying myself of all emotion, I was made tranquil and didn't even know. Then the vigil summoned the spirit of faith to touch my mind. That broke tranquility and gave me my abilities. The Seekers did not share that secret. Not with me, not with the Chantry, not even with... There's more. Lucius was not wrong about the Order. I thought to rebuild the Seekers once victory was ours. Now I'm not certain it deserves to be rebuilt.
You said there was more in the book.
At some point, power becomes its own master. We cast aside ideals in favor of expedience and tell ourselves it was all necessary for the people. Will that happen to us, Inquisitor? Will we repeat history?
I can't foresee the future, Cassandra.
But we know the past. Those who do not heed history are doomed to repeat it.
I don't think I've ever seen you so shaken.
I do not think the Seekers have been doing the Maker's work. Not truly. Perhaps we believed it once. The original Inquisition came to be during a terrible time. But now, we harbored secrets and let them fester. We acted to survive, but not to serve. That is not the Maker's work.
If you did rebuild the Seekers, how would you do it?
I can't be the only one remaining. We will always spread to the winds, and some may still be out there. I would find them one by one. We would all read this book. No more secrets. Then together we would establish a new charter. The Maker's work in truth.
You keep saying that, but what is the Maker's work?
There is no way to know for certain. That is why we must seek it out. Perhaps we lost our way because we stopped looking.
If anyone can rebuild them into something worthwhile, you can.
But are they worth rebuilding?
You could make them worth it.
I will think on your words. Thank you. I could not have done this on my own. Is there anything you need?
I want to talk to you about the cure for tranquility.
It's not a cure. Not truly. Mages who were once tranquil lose all control over their emotions. They become irrational, unable to focus. Perhaps that state eventually passes and they can be helped, but it will take time to investigate.
But you are going to look into it.
That is my intent. I would not want news of a cure to spread until we know for certain we can help these people. Once we have that, however, then I will spread the word myself.
I have some more questions.
As you wish.
Tell me about your brother.
Anthony was older than I, a dragon hunter, who showed what a Pentaghast could truly be. I idolized him. I wanted to hunt dragons as he did, even though our uncle forbade it. Anthony promised to train me in secret. We would hunt together one day, brother and sister, vanquishing the beasts of old. And then he died on me.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have pried.
No, it's fine. A group of apostates wanted dragon blood, and wanted Anthony to get it for them. He refused, and they killed him for it. In front of me. I begged the Chantry to let me become a Templar. Instead, they sent me to the Seekers. It took many years to let go of my drive for vengeance.
I think I understand how you felt.
At times I could not breathe. The rage nearly choked me. I sometimes wonder how different my life would be if Anthony was still alive. Would I be a dragon hunter? Married to some noble fool, a mother of three? I cannot say. I take solace in believing the Maker has a plan, but he is not always kind.
I'll let you get back to work. Planning troop movements now?
I'm trying to imagine what it will look like when we're done. All of this once belonged to the Tevinter Imperium. Andraste changed that. As did the Blights. As for what will come next, I cannot guess the Maker's plan.
Maybe there is no plan. We get the world we make, nothing more.
Then how do we determine the right choices to make? I know I want a world where people trust the Chantry and that trust is respected. I want to respect tradition, but not fear change. I want to right past wrongs, but not avenge them. And I have no idea if my wanting these things makes any of them right.
You don't think those things are a bit idealistic?
Once I might have. Today, I live in a time when anything seems possible.
Anything doesn't mean everything, or even something good.
That will not stop me from trying. Tell me, what guides you? You make decisions that shake the world, yet always seem so assured. I wish I had your confidence.
You almost sound like you admire me.
I absolutely do. I may not always agree with your decisions, but how many could do what you have done? You were a prisoner, accused and reviled, yet you've emerged from every trial victorious. The Maker's grace does not make you immortal. You live or die by your own hand. That is worthy of admiration.
If I'm guided by anything, it's you.
Oh, excellent. The blind leading the blind.
I don't think you're blind.
Clearly, you haven't been paying attention.
Haven't I?
When we first met, if someone told me I would be pleased to have you lead me, I would have throttled them. But I am. The Maker chose well.
I don't believe I was chosen, remember?
Oh, I'm well aware. We still have a long road to travel, Inquisitor. Wherever it takes us, I'm glad you're here.
Good book?
Ah! I don't know what you're talking about.
Wait, are you blushing?
What would I have to blush about?
You tell me.
It's of no interest to you, I'm certain. It's a book.
I can see that.
It's one of Varric's tales. Swords and Shields, the latest chapter.
So you like to read. What's wrong with that?
It's frivolous. There are more important things for me to do.
That's just her favorite.
Nobody asked you, Tevinter.
I couldn't finish the last one you lent me. I actually feel dumber for having tried.
It's literature. Smutty literature. Whatever you do, don't tell Varric.
Maybe I should read that book.
You? No!
Why not me?
You're the Inquisitor.
Oh, I see.
They're terrible. And magnificent. And this one ends in a cliffhanger. I know Varric is working on the next. He must be. You could ask him to finish it. Command him to... Pretend you don't know this about me.
I've got a minute if you need something.
Cassandra is waiting for the next issue of Swords and Shields.
I must have heard that wrong. It sounded like you just said that Cassandra read my books.
She's a pretty big fan, in fact.
Are we talking about the same Cassandra? Tall, grumpy seeker, like stabbing things? Wait, did you say the romance serial? Oh, she'll be waiting for a while then. I haven't finished it and wasn't planning to. That book is easily the worst I've ever written. The last issue barely sold enough to pay for the ink.
Well, Cassandra seems to be hooked on it.
And I honestly thought a hole in the sky was the weirdest thing that could happen. So, you want me to finish writing the latest issue of my worst serial? For Cassandra? Oh, that's such a terrible idea. I have to do it. on one condition. I get to be there when you give her the book.
You've got a deal.
I'll get to work then. You know, the fact that the book is terrible just makes it more worthwhile somehow.
What have you done now?
I get it, Seeker. You're still sore after our spat.
I'm not a child, Varric. Do not suggest I'm without reason.
A peace offering. The next chapter of Swords and Shields. I hear you're a fan.
This is your doing.
I was hoping you'd be happy about it.
Well, if you're not interested, you're not interested. Still needs editing anyhow.
Wait!
You're probably wondering what happens to the Night Captain after the last chapter.
Nothing should happen to her. She was falsely accused.
Well, it turns out the guardsman...
Don't tell me!
This is the part where you thank the Inquisitor. I don't normally give sneak peeks, after all.
I... thank you.
Varric's the one you should be thanking.
I am but a humble servant to my loyal readers.
I wonder if I have time to read the first part.
Don't forget to tell all your friends, if you have any. Completely worth it.
Is there anything you need?
So that book you were reading.
Yes, what of it?
So under that taciturn shell beats a true romantic heart.
Why must it be an accusation? Romance is not the sole province of dithering ladies in frilly dresses. It is passion. It is being swept away by the pursuit of an ideal. What is not to like about that?
And don't get me wrong, I like this side of you.
I don't swoon.
I meant the passion.
Oh. Well, that's not so bad then. Writing does not come naturally to me, as I'm certain you can imagine.
Let me guess, you're composing a love poem.
I couldn't, not even if my life depended on it.
It's not that hard.
Yes, it is. Poetry takes finesse, it takes grace.
You think you don't have those things?
Historians will one day ask what happened at Adamant Fortress, in the Fade. I was there. I saw it with my own eyes. It must be recorded.
Fair enough. Just be careful what you write.
Do not be concerned. I am a poor writer, but not unaware of the weight my words might carry. I still don't know what to say about the spirit of the divine. I saw her there, heard her voice, yet I cannot claim with certainty it was really her. The chantry teaches us that the souls of the dead pass through the Fade, so it could have been her, yet even so.
Do you really think it might have been her? A ghost?
A ghost? A remnant of her hopes and memories. Her lingering will to do good. Those things are all possible. Nobody knows for certain what happens after we die. A spirit could have assumed her form, but why? It helped you, as Justinia herself would have.
Perhaps it doesn't matter what she really was then.
It matters to me, to what I must write. I must interpret what I saw, yet I am no priest, no philosopher. I am a warrior.
I don't know the truth any more than you do.
Sadly, unanswered questions make for poor reading. When I realized we were physically in the Fade, I was terrified, almost beyond reason. The last time such a thing happened, we created Darkspawn. We created Corypheus. The world needs to know the truth this time. No more legends lost to the ages. I was hoping we could speak privately.
Are we not?
Right. Of course we are. The flirting. With me. I've noticed it. Unless it is my imagination, which is entirely possible.
No, it's not your imagination.
You cannot court me if that's your intention. It's impossible.
Did you just say I can't court you?
Yes. What of it?
It's just a bit formal.
And that is a bad thing? I cannot be properly courted.
Is that what you want?
No. Oh, I take it back. That is what I want. I want a man who sweeps me off my feet, who gives me flowers and reads me poetry by candlelight. I want the ideal. You are the Inquisitor and the Herald of Andraste. You cannot be that man.
I didn't expect you to feel this way.
I know what you see. I am a warrior. I am blunt and difficult and self-righteous. But my heart lies beneath all that. It yearns for these things I cannot have. If you cannot see that, then desist. What enamors you is but the surface.
I can be that man, Cassandra.
The world hinges on our actions. We face death at every turn, Inquisitor.
That doesn't change how I feel.
It changes everything. I cannot stop thinking of our earlier discussion. You don't actually intend to go through with courting me, do you?
I said I would, and I will.
I believe you, yet...
You don't sound like you believe me.
It wasn't a challenge, my lord. You needn't do it simply because I suggested you could not.
It's very simple. I care for you.
You enjoy making things complicated, don't you?
That's enough for now.
We shall speak again soon. I trust all is well.
I'd like to speak with you. In private.
Oh? How private?
There's a grove just outside of Skyhold. Meet me there.
If you're certain...
I am. Trust me.
On aching branch do blossoms grow, the wind a hallowed breath. It carries the scent of honeysuckle, sweet as the lover's kiss. It brings the promise of more tomorrows, of sighs and whispered bliss.
You can't be serious.
As I recall, your list was very specific.
And that is the poem you chose?
Oh, so the list is more detailed than I thought.
Carmenum de Amatus. I thought this one was banned. His lips on mine speak words not voiced, a prayer, which travels down my spine like flames that shatter night. His eyes reflect the heaven stars, the Maker's light. My body opens, filled and blessed, my spirit there.
Not merely housed in flesh, but brought to life. Shall we read another?
Thank you. They will say one of two things about me. That I stood at the Inquisitor's side, his protector and his lover. That it was meant to be. Or they will say I was led from the path of faith by the wiles of a madman.
I don't care what they say. What do you believe?
I believe you are the herald of Andraste, even if you do not. Beyond that, I believe only that you are capable of anything. And it frightens me. I have never known anything like it. I've been with only one other man in my life. A mage, with whom I adventured when I was still very young. He died at the Conclave. I will not let Corypheus win. I will not let him take you from me.
I love you.
Here, tonight, I believe you. You are quite distracting, you know.
I was hoping we could spend some time together.
What could we possibly do to pass the time? I can't believe you escaped before me. A fat count insisted on talking about soup for 15 minutes. We can return to Skyhold whenever you like. The sooner the better. Is something wrong?
I'm just worn out. Tonight has been very long.
It was a lot of foolishness. But we did strike a blow against Corypheus. We will need to put the soldiers at Skyhold on alert. Better to be safe.
Wait. There is one thing we must do before we go. May I have this dance, Lady Cassandra?
A dance? After all we've been through tonight?
Can you think of a better way to celebrate?
I suppose this isn't terrible.
Will you not consider it, Lady Cassandra? The clerics are still sequestered. If no one steps forward, they will debate until...
And you think I could make them agree? I've heard enough for one day, Mother Giselle.
Talk to her, Your Worship.
The fun never ends in Skyhold, does it?
The Inquisitor was hilarious. That's what they'll say one day, you watch. I assume you've heard that Leliana and I are both candidates to be the next Divine. Because of what happened at Halam Shiral, of course, the Empire favors you, thus everyone close to you. So now the Chantry bandies our names about without even asking us first.
How can you and Leliana be candidates? You're not even priests.
It's not without precedent. Amar III was sister to the Emperor, and Galatea a commoner. Leliana and I were, at least, part of the Chantry hierarchy. It would be accepted.
If they'll pick non-priests, why am I not a candidate?
Because you're a man, first and foremost. If they name you a candidate, they may as well join the Tevinter Imperium. Truly, though, I imagine it's because they're frightened of you. A weight such as yours would break the Sunburst Throne and tear the Chantry to pieces. I just don't know why they believe Leliana or I would be any better.
If you don't want it, then tell them so.
Surely it was never meant to be like this. The Chantry, the Circle of Magi, the Templars, this cannot be what they intended when it all began. The Chantry should provide faith, hope, Instead, it cannot veer from its course, even in the face of certain death.
I'm surprised to hear you, of all people, say that.
Oh? Am I not the same woman who declared the Inquisition against the Chantry's wishes? In all my years as a Seeker, I did what I was told. My faith demanded it. But now my faith demands something else, that I see with better eyes.
The Chantry has failed, Cassandra.
I wonder if the legions of faithful throughout Thedas would agree with you. Did you know Varric is Andrastian? Oh, he blasphemes with every second breath, but deep down he believes. His heart is virtuous. But he would never step foot in a Chantry. It should be the first place to which the virtuous turn. It needs to change. Perhaps I must be the one to change it.
You're not the only candidate. What about Leliana?
Leliana says she wishes to follow Justinia's legacy. But she and I remember a different person. Justinia knew her fellow clerics and the people would only accept so much change. Leliana would cast it all aside and start over, I think. And that would be chaos for us all.
What would you change about the Chantry?
The Circle of Magi has its place, but it needs reform. Let the mages govern themselves with our help. Let the Templars stand not as the jailers of mages, but as protectors of the innocent. We must be vigilant, but we must also be compassionate to all peoples of Thedas, human or no. That is what I would change.
Your determination is admirable.
Some men would call it an unattractive trait.
I'm not those men.
Truer words have not been spoken.
Who's using flattery now? Perhaps the Chantry needs more than just change.
You mean get rid of it entirely? I disagree. Without the Chantry, the faithful would be lost. The Chantry must simply be more responsible in how it leads. I suppose I should not be so concerned. The clerics speak my name for now, nothing more. For now, restoring order and stopping Corypheus remain our priority. The sight of you warms the heart.
So you're a candidate for Divine now?
So I am informed.
Is that something you actually want?
Why should what I want matter?
Why shouldn't it matter? Don't you have the right to be happy?
It is very simple. The Chantry needs to survive. To do that, it must change. I have never believed in asking another to do what you are unwilling to do yourself. So I look upon this as an opportunity. I owe it to myself and all of Thedas to seek the Sunburst Throne.
There are other ways you can change things.
Perhaps. I may not have a choice in the matter if the Chantry clerics pick another.
That's enough for now.
We shall speak again soon. Victory in the Arbor Wilds. The Archdemon might have been a real threat to our army, but it flew off once we turned the tide. It is still out there, however. I wonder what Corypheus plans now.
We'll deal with whatever he throws at us.
Do not underestimate Corypheus. He is powerful, and you have yet to fight him one-on-one. But he will come. You will get your chance.
We'll face Corypheus together.
There is not another man I would be more proud to fight beside. Not long ago, this was impossible to imagine. You, the man I love, victory close at hand. The time has come to consider what will come next.
I don't care what's next, as long as we're together.
And if I am named Divine?
I won't lose you to the Chantry.
You haven't lost me yet.
I can't believe it's over. It seemed an impossible task. Defy the Chantry,
build the Inquisition from nothing, defeat a creature that would be a god. And yet here we are, celebrating.
What's important is that you're here with me.
There was a moment after the orb exploded. I thought for certain you were dead. I prayed, don't take him from me, not after all we've been through. And then I saw you through the smoke. Sometimes the Maker is kind. I intend to rebuild the Seekers of Truth, to make us the order we were meant to be. That will take time. Meanwhile, I am free to remain here, with you. I think back to how we first met, and here you stand. You are the Inquisitor, a symbol of hope and change to so many. And you are the man I love. How did that happen, I wonder? Know that I will always stand with you. A moment before you go. There's something else I wanted to say.
Oh? Lead on. What's this about?
Everything is about to change. You will be drawn in 100 different directions in the weeks and months to come.
Cassandra.
No, it's fine. I simply wanted to steal a moment while I still can. It was dangerous knowledge. The shock of its discovery in addition to what happened in Kirkwall. But it appears we've always known how to reverse the right. From the beginning.
That doesn't surprise me at all.
We created the Rite of Tranquility. I told you of my vigil, the months I spent emptying myself of all emotion. I was made tranquil, and didn't even know. Then the vigil summoned a spirit of faith to touch my mind. That broke tranquility, and gave me my abilities. The Seekers did not share that secret. Not with me, not with the Chantry, not even with... There's more. Lucius was not wrong about the Order. I thought to rebuild the Seekers once victory was ours. Now I'm not certain it deserves to be rebuilt.
You said there was more in the book.
At some point, power becomes its own master. We cast aside ideals in favor of expedience and tell ourselves it was all necessary for the people. Will that happen to us, Inquisitor? Will we repeat history?
I can't foresee the future, Cassandra.
But we know the past. Those who do not heed history are doomed to repeat it.
I don't think I've ever seen you so shaken.
I do not think the Seekers have been doing the Maker's work. Not truly. Perhaps we believed it once. The original Inquisition came to be during a terrible time. But now, we harbored secrets and let them fester. We acted to survive, but not to serve. That is not the Maker's work.
If you did rebuild the Seekers, how would you do it?
I can't be the only one remaining. We will always spread to the winds, and some may still be out there. I would find them one by one. We would all read this book, no more secrets. Then together we would establish a new charter. The Maker's work in truth.
You keep saying that. But what is the Maker's work?
There is no way to know for certain. That is why we must seek it out. Perhaps we lost our way because we stopped looking.
If anyone can rebuild them into something worthwhile, you can.
But are they worth rebuilding?
You could make them worth it.
I will think on your words. Thank you. I could not have done this on my own. Is there anything you need?
I want to talk to you about the cure for tranquility.
It's not a cure. Not truly. Mages who were once tranquil lose all control over their emotions. They become irrational, unable to focus. Perhaps that state eventually passes and they can be helped, but it will take time to investigate.
But you are going to look into it.
That is my intent. I would not want news of a cure to spread until we know for certain we can help these people. Once we have that, however, then I will spread the word myself.
I have some more questions.
As you wish.
Tell me about your brother.
Anthony was older than I, a dragon hunter, who showed what a Pentaghast could truly be. I idolized him. I wanted to hunt dragons as he did, even though our uncle forbade it. Anthony promised to train me in secret. We would hunt together one day, brother and sister, vanquishing the beasts of old. And then he died on me.
I'm sorry. I shouldn't have pried.
No, it's fine. A group of apostates wanted dragon blood, and wanted Anthony to get it for them. He refused, and they killed him for it. In front of me. I begged the Chantry to let me become a Templar. Instead, they sent me to the Seekers. It took many years to let go of my drive for vengeance.
I think I understand how you felt.
At times I could not breathe. The rage nearly choked me. I sometimes wonder how different my life would be if Anthony was still alive. Would I be a dragon hunter? Married to some noble fool, a mother of three? I cannot say. I take solace in believing the Maker has a plan, but he is not always kind.
I'll let you get back to work. Planning troop movements now?
I'm trying to imagine what it will look like when we're done. All of this once belonged to the Tevinter Imperium. Andraste changed that, as did the Blights. As for what will come next... I cannot guess the Maker's plan.
Maybe there is no plan. We get the world we make, nothing more.
Then how do we determine the right choices to make? I know I want a world where people trust the Chantry and that trust is respected. I want to respect tradition, but not fear change. I want to right past wrongs, but not avenge them. And I have no idea if my wanting these things makes any of them right.
You don't think those things are a bit idealistic?
Once I might have. Today, I live in a time when anything seems possible.
Anything doesn't mean everything, or even something good.
That will not stop me from trying. Tell me, what guides you? You make decisions that shake the world, yet always seem so assured. I wish I had your confidence.
You almost sound like you admire me.
I absolutely do. I may not always agree with your decisions, but how many could do what you have done? You were a prisoner, accused and reviled, yet you've emerged from every trial victorious. The Maker's grace does not make you immortal. You live or die by your own hand. That is worthy of admiration.
If I'm guided by anything, it's you.
Oh, excellent. The blind leading the blind.
I don't think you're blind.
Clearly, you haven't been paying attention.
Haven't I?
When we first met, if someone told me I would be pleased to have you lead me, I would have throttled them. But I am. The Maker chose well.
I don't believe I was chosen, remember?
Oh, I'm well aware. We still have a long road to travel, Inquisitor. Wherever it takes us, I'm glad you're here.
Good book?
Oh, I don't know what you're talking about.
Wait, are you blushing?
What would I have to blush about?
You tell me.
It's of no interest to you, I'm certain. It's a book.
I can see that.
It's one of Varric's tales. Swords and Shields, the latest chapter.
So you like to read? What's wrong with that?
It's frivolous. There are more important things for me to do.
That's just her favorite.
Nobody asked you, Tevinter.
I couldn't finish the last one you lent me. I actually feel dumber for having tried.
It's literature. Smutty literature. Whatever you do, don't tell Varric.
Maybe I should read that book.
You? No!
Why not me?
You're the Inquisitor.
Oh, I see.
They're terrible. And magnificent. And this one ends in a cliffhanger. I know Varric is working on the next. He must be. You could ask him to finish it. Command him to... Pretend you don't know this about me.
I've got a minute if you need something.
Cassandra is waiting for the next issue of Swords and Shields.
I must have heard that wrong. It sounded like you just said that Cassandra read my books.
She's a pretty big fan, in fact.
Are we talking about the same Cassandra? Tall, grumpy seeker, likes stabbing things? Wait, did you say the romance serial? Oh, she'll be waiting for a while then. I haven't finished it and wasn't planning to. That book is easily the worst I've ever written. The last issue barely sold enough to pay for the ink.
Well, Cassandra seems to be hooked on it.
And I honestly thought a hole in the sky was the weirdest thing that could happen. So, you want me to finish writing the latest issue of my worst serial? For Cassandra? Oh, that's such a terrible idea. I have to do it. On one condition. I get to be there when you give her the book.
You've got a deal.
I'll get to work then. You know, the fact that the book is terrible just makes it more worthwhile somehow.
What have you done now?
I get it, Seeker. You're still sore after our spat.
I'm not a child, Varric. Do not suggest I'm without reason.
A peace offering. The next chapter of Swords and Shields. I hear you're a fan.
This is your doing.
I was hoping you'd be happy about it.
Well, if you're not interested, you're not interested. Still needs editing anyhow.
Wait!
You're probably wondering what happens to the Night Captain after the last chapter.
Nothing should happen to her. She was forced...
You're kind of a force of nature, aren't you?
When I need to be.
It's impressive.
You flatter me.
I'm trying.
Did I do the right thing? What I have set in motion here could destroy everything I have revered my whole life. One day they may write about me as a traitor, a madwoman, a fool. And they may be right.
What does your faith tell you?
I believe you are innocent. I believe more is going on here than we can see. And I believe no one else cares to do anything about it. They will stand in the fire and complain that it is hot. But is this the Maker's will? I can only guess.
What's going to happen now?
Now? We deal with the Chantry's panic over you before they do even more harm. Then we close the breach. We are the only ones who can. After that, we find out who is responsible for this chaos, and we end them. And if there are consequences to be paid for what I have done, I pay them. I only pray the price is not too high.
You didn't have any choice.
Didn't I? My trainers always said, Cassandra, you are too brash. You must think before you act. I see what must be done, and I do it. I see no point in running around in circles like a dog chasing its tail. But I misjudged you in the beginning, did I not? I thought the answer was before me, clear as day. I cannot afford to be so careless again.
Can't say I'm not grateful to hear that.
I can be harsh, I know. You've said you don't believe you're chosen. Does that mean you also don't believe in the Maker?
I can't really say.
I suppose it doesn't matter now. I have to believe we were put on this path for a reason, even if you do not. Now it simply remains to see where it leads us. It occurs to me I don't actually know much about you.
What do you want to know?
I'm not sure. Where are you from?
I thought you knew that.
I suppose I could ask Liliana. She has collected a frightening amount of information on you. But I don't want to ask her. I want to hear it from you.
The Circle of Magi at Ostwick. At least until the rebellion began.
Yes, I suppose that would have required you to stay on the move. Tell me, do you consider the Free March as your home? Are you eager to go back?
Wherever I am is home enough for me.
That's how I feel now, after years of tending to business for the Divine.
I'd like to get to know you better.
You would?
Is that a problem?
Not entirely. I'm just curious as to your motivation.
Is there any harm in us becoming a little closer?
Plenty.
Is that right?
As you wish. My name is Cassandra Pentaghast, daughter of the Royal House of Navarra, 78th in line for the Navarran throne. I joined the Seekers of Truth as a young woman, and was with the Order until they withdrew from the Chantry. I remained as the Divine's right hand, carrying out her order to form the Inquisition. And here we are. That's all there is to know, my lord.
You're a member of Navarra's royal family.
The Pentaghasts are a very large clan. Half of Cumberland could say the same.
Really?
No, but it feels that way. I have hundreds of relatives so distant they need charts to prove we're related at all. And they have them. Oh, yes. The Pentaghasts value their precious blood like it runs with gold.
They're not on very good terms with your family, then.
I do not visit, if that's what you mean. The Pentaghasts are famed for dragon hunting, but few actually pursue the craft. Most are fat and lazy. They pay lip service to the Maker and care only for idle pleasures and past glories. My brother was all that kept me in Navarra. Once he was gone, so was I.
Tell me about your brother.
I would prefer not to speak of Anthony. Another time, perhaps.
You don't seem to like your homeland much.
My family polluted it for me. What little I saw of my homeland was through the bars of a gilded cage. My uncle treated me like a porcelain doll to be placed on a shelf and dusted only when necessary. Thus, I did not see Navarra, the real Navarra, until much later. By then, I realized I knew it not at all.
Your uncle? What about your parents?
They had the misfortune of taking the wrong side in the second attempt to overthrow King Marcus. The king executed them, but spared my brother and I since we were family and children at the time. Thus, we were raised by my uncle. A mortal Etasi who preferred the company of his corpses to the living.
Your uncle was a mortal Etasi?
A death mage. He still is. My countrymen do not burn the dead, they bury them in special crypts. The mortal Etasi supervise the crypts, like priests. Uncle Vestalus oversees the grand necropolis. Navarans spend more time honoring dead relatives than they do with living ones. It is odd to be so fascinated with death and its trappings. I will never understand it.
So you were the right hand to the Divine?
To Divine Justinia, yes. And Divine Beatrix before her, in fact. The position is normally reserved for Templars of the Knights Divine, but my circumstances were unusual.
Unusual how?
You don't know the story? Thank the Maker. I will tell you if you wish, but it isn't as exciting as some drum it up to be. The short version is that I once saved the previous Divine's life. My reward was becoming her right hand.
But what does a right hand do exactly?
What is your hand capable of? It gives, it takes, it beckons, it makes a fist. Liliana and I extended the Divine's reach beyond the Grand Cathedral. We went where she could not. After Beatrix, I was tired of the position and wanted to return to the Seekers. But Justinia convinced me to stay. Her vision for the future gave me hope.
You thought she could really change things?
Justinia knew the war was coming long before it began. She tried to avert it, but the forces arrayed against her were too strong. Sometimes you have to break a bone so it can be reset. That's where the Inquisition comes in. It was to be the answer. A means to preserve as well as an agent for change. I only wish she had lived to see it.
So what's the story about you becoming the right hand?
Sweet Andraste, do you really want to hear that? It was, what, 18, 20 years ago? Some still discuss it like it happened yesterday. The tale gets bigger each time it's told. I barely recognize myself within it now.
I'm sure you're just being modest.
I was there. I think I know what happened. To hear others tell it, I alone saved Divine Beatrix from a horde of dragons sent to assault the Grand Cathedral. Rather impressive for such a young seeker, wouldn't you say?
And the truth is?
I stumbled upon a conspiracy to kill Beatrix. A Templar Knight Commander was at its heart. And there was a dragon battle at the Grand Cathedral. But I had help from loyal mages who rallied to the cause. They freed the dragons from magical control. Without them, the Divine and I would both have died. Yet I became the right hand, and they are forgotten.
What happened to the mages that helped you?
They went back to their circles, with rewards and privileges and Most Holy's gratitude. Many of them died at the conflict.
You're delightful, you know that?
No, I do not know that.
Mm-hmm.
I object. There is nothing delightful about me.
I beg to differ.
I think I preferred you in the stocks.
I'll let you get back to work.
Yes?
Can you tell me more about the Seekers?
The Seekers of Truth were born from the original Inquisition long ago, when it united with the Chantry. Seekers stood above the Templars, watching over them, but also investigating magical events they couldn't handle. We were meant to be incorruptible, above reproach. How seldom does reality match the ideal?
But what are Seekers exactly?
Those who know anything of us think we are Templars. We do not use Lyrium, however. Our abilities are different, as was our original purpose. We discipline the Templars and were accountable only to the Divine. And not even her, truthfully.
So the Seekers commanded the Templars?
No. The Order didn't assume command until after the rebellion. The Templars have always feared us. When a Seeker arrived at a circle, they knew trouble was afoot. That kind of power is troubling. You begin to think you are the only one who can solve the world's problems. If you don't see a problem, it doesn't exist. If someone insists it does, they are the blind ones.
Do you think that kind of problem could ever be fixed?
Possibly. Though the Seekers themselves would need to change. They were clearly not willing to, even though they abandoned everything they stood for to avoid it. In my heart, I believe they can still be salvaged, but not by their own hands.
How does someone become a Seeker?
Most Seekers begin training in their youth. I was much older, an exception due to my noble birth. We train rigorously for years. Our bodies and minds must be elastic to undergo the vigil, and most fail even then.
Is the vigil some kind of initiation?
It is the rite every Seeker must go through in order to summon their gifts. A full year of fasting, prayer, and separation from all distractions, including other people. We empty ourselves of all emotion, focusing only on the purity of our devotion. And the moment it finally ends, it's wonderful. Faith realized. I cannot put it into words.
I wish I could experience that.
If the vigil was not so arduous, I'd say more should attempt it. What if mages never needed to fear possession by demons? I'm told it is impossible, however. I suppose I'll never know the truth of it now.
Why did your order turn against the Chantry?
We originally united with the Chantry through a treaty that stated they would keep mages under control. It was felt Most Holy had tacitly allowed the Circle of Magi to vote on its independence, thus breaking the treaty. The Seekers saw themselves as justified, and they led the Templars into a war of righteousness.
You sound like you disagree.
We knew what was happening at Kirkwall, where the Mage Rebellion began. We looked into reports of Knight Commander Meredith's harsh treatment of her charges years earlier. But we found so many shocking cases of magical corruption, it was decided her actions were justified. If we'd been there when it happened, if we'd looked harder at the root causes...
You seem to care a great deal about it.
Too much, if you ask the rest of my order. When faced with a problem, the Seekers would close ranks and crush it. We would find an answer, but only once we felt we weren't being coerced. The moment the mages voted for independence, our response was predictable. It was difficult to watch.
You mentioned that Seekers have different abilities than Templars.
Entirely. A Templar's abilities come from Lyrium and are designed to hunt mages. Ours come from ritual and many years of dedicated training. We cannot be possessed by demons and are immune to mind control. Useful, considering our role. Seekers can gain other gifts, but that depends on the individual.
What kind of gifts do you have?
I can set the Lyrium within a person's blood aflame. Both mages and Templars bend before my will. Some Seekers use it to interrogate, others simply to paralyze. Once there was a Seeker who could use it to kill. That particular gift is considered rare.
I've no more questions.
Do you need something?
May I ask you about the Chantry?
It is difficult to say what becomes of the Chantry now. They have no Templars, no leadership, and no one left who is worthy of succeeding the Divine. It has fallen apart when everyone needs it the most. I ache to think what this will mean in the days to come.
Do you really believe the Chantry is worth preserving?
If you ask my opinion, it is. Absolutely. Cast the Chantry aside and new problems replace old ones. We will have learned nothing from history. The people need stability, and the Chantry needs a new purpose. Ondraste had a dream for us. It can still be achieved.
So what should that new purpose be?
A dedication to what is truly important. Instead of building cathedrals and sewing gowns for the Divine, the Chantry used to spend its coin feeding the poor. If we are to spread the Maker's word across the world, we must do so with open hearts and open hands.
That sounds rather idealistic of you.
Does it? I do not think it's so unachievable. The Chantry has many good, honest people. They just need direction and inspiration. They need to be freed from centuries of adherence to tradition and ceremony. A chance for renewal is at our fingertips. It does not have to come with utter chaos.
I'm surprised you rebelled against the Chantry.
I left my own order when they took the wrong path. It is no different. But in neither case did I stop caring. Indeed, I care so much that I feel drastic action is necessary. I suppose history shall one day judge my actions.
Will the Chantry replace Divine Justinian?
They will try. Once the priests withdraw for the Grand Consensus, it is against Chantry law for them to emerge without naming a new divine. Sometimes it takes days, or weeks, or even months. The problem now is that no clear successor to Justinia exists. All worthy clerics died with her at the conclave.
So what happens if they can't agree on someone?
Theoretically, they will argue until exhaustion takes them or they see reason. Practically, however, if the Grand Consensus goes on too long, the Chantry will crumble. Any cleric with ambition but little sense will see this as her one chance, and plenty of such clerics exist. We shall see what happens. The Inquisition must act in the meantime.
If they do choose a new divine, will you serve her?
That depends on whether she would have me. I am a rebel now, remember? And even if she would, I do not know. It would depend on what type of divine she is. I am no longer in a position to follow blindly, and no new divine could expect such obedience now.
What influence does Chancellor Roderick really wield?
He's a bureaucrat, responsible for communicating the divine's will to the rest of the Chantry. Therefore, he's accustomed to the clerics hanging on his every word, hoping his influence will benefit them. Despite that, Roderick is not a bad man. He's frightened, and believes his place is to fill the gap left by Most Holy's death. Some might agree. As far down the chain of command as he is, there is no one left above.
How big a problem could he be?
No more than he is already. He sent his message to the College of Clerics. That is the only card he had to play. Dealing with him further only lends him credibility he doesn't deserve.
Thank you.
And what are we supposed to do, exactly?
What you always do. Complain.
We've already spoken with Commander Cullen. No one listens. We want better quarters. We want the Templars kept at a distance. And some respect for...
This is not the Circle. You mages are our allies, not our wards. Act like it.
How are we supposed to...
deal with it. It never ends, evidently.
Is there an issue with the mages? Can I help?
The mages are here as equals. They need to get used to what that means. It is your doing, after all. You created this alliance.
Well, I hope it works. What other choice do we have?
Oh. I do sound like I'm blaming you, don't I? I don't disapprove. In fact, you did well. You made a decision when it needed to be made. And here we are. I wish I could say this was my doing.
You're flattering me.
I'm not. This always happens. Nobody ever takes my meaning.
You should see your face.
I'm thinking less flattering things now. Let's hope the breach has your sense of humor. You knew where Hawk was all along.
You're damned right I did.
You conniving little shit.
You kidnapped me. You interrogated me. What did you expect?
Hey, enough.
You're taking his side?
I said enough.
We needed someone to lead this Inquisition. Hawk was our only hope. He was the champion of Kirkwall. The mages respected him. And you kept him from us.
The Inquisition has a leader.
Hawk would have been at the Conclave if anyone could have saved Most Holy.
You can't change the past, Cassandra.
So I must accept... what? That the Maker wanted all this to happen? That he... That Varric is a liar, Inquisitor. A snake. Even after the Conclave, when we needed Hawk most, Varric kept him secret.
He's with us now. We're on the same side.
We all know whose side you're on, Varric. It will never be the Inquisition's.
Attacking him now won't help us, Cassandra.
Ha! Exactly!
And you better not be keeping anything else from us.
I understand.
I must not think of what could have been. We have so much at stake. Go, Varric. Just go.
You know what I think? If Hawk had been at the temple, he'd be dead too. You people have done enough to him.
I believed him. He spun his story for me and I swallowed it. If I'd just explained what was at stake, if I'd just made him understand. But I didn't, did I? I didn't explain why we needed Hawk. I'm such a fool.
Good thing I still like you.
I'm serious.
You think I'm not?
I want you to know. I have no regrets. The accused!
Well, it turns out the guardsman...
Don't tell me!
This is the part where you thank the Inquisitor. I don't normally give sneak peeks, after all.
I... thank you.
Varric's the one you should be thanking.
I am but a humble servant to my loyal readers.
I wonder if I have time to read the first part.
Don't forget to tell all your friends, if you have any. Completely worth it.
Is there anything you need?
So that book you were reading.
Yes, what of it?
So under that taciturn shell beats a true romantic heart.
Why must it be an accusation? Romance is not the sole province of dithering ladies in frilly dresses. It is passion. It is being swept away by the pursuit of an ideal. What is not to like about that?
And don't get me wrong, I like this side of you.
I don't swoon.
I meant the passion.
Ah. Well, that's not so bad then. Writing does not come naturally to me, as I'm certain you can imagine.
Let me guess, you're composing a love poem.
I couldn't, not even if my life depended on it.
It's not that hard.
Yes. It is. Poetry takes finesse. It takes... grace.
You think you don't have those things?
Historians will one day ask what happened at Adamant Fortress, in the Fade. I was there. I saw it with my own eyes. It must be recorded.
Fair enough. Just be careful what you write.
Do not be concerned. I am a poor writer, but not unaware of the weight my words might carry. I still don't know what to say about the spirit of the divine. I saw her there, heard her voice, yet I cannot claim with certainty it was really her. The Chantry teaches us that the souls of the dead pass through the Fade, so it could have been her. Yet even so...
Do you really think it might have been her? A ghost?
A ghost? A remnant of her hopes and memories. Her lingering will to do good. Those things are all possible. Nobody knows for certain what happens after we die. A spirit could have assumed her form. But why? It helped you. As Justinia herself would have.
Perhaps it doesn't matter what she really was, then.
It matters to me, to what I must write. I must interpret what I saw, yet I am no priest, no philosopher. I am a warrior.
I don't know the truth any more than you do.
Sadly, unanswered questions make for poor reading. When I realized we were physically in the Fade, I was terrified, almost beyond reason. The last time such a thing happened, we created Darkspawn. We created Corypheus. The world needs to know the truth this time. No more legends lost to the ages. I was hoping we could speak privately.
Are we not?
Right. Of course we are. The flirting. With me. I've noticed it. Unless it is my imagination, which is entirely possible.
No, it's not your imagination.
You cannot court me if that's your intention. It's impossible.
Did you just say I can't court you?
Yes. What of it?
It's just a bit formal.
And that is a bad thing? I cannot be properly courted.
Is that what you want?
No. Oh, I take it back. That is what I want. I want a man who sweeps me off my feet, who gives me flowers and reads me poetry by candlelight. I want the ideal. You are the Inquisitor and the Herald of Andraste. You cannot be that man.
I didn't expect you to feel this way.
I know what you see. I am a warrior. I am blunt and difficult and self-righteous. But my heart lies beneath all that. It yearns for these things I cannot have. If you cannot see that, then desist. What enamors you is but the surface.
I can be that man, Cassandra.
The world hinges on our actions. We face death at every turn, Inquisitor.
That doesn't change how I feel.
It changes everything. I cannot stop thinking of our earlier discussion. You don't actually intend to go through with courting me, do you?
I said I would, and I will.
I believe you, yet...
You don't sound like you believe me.
It wasn't a challenge, my lord. You needn't do it simply because I suggested you could not.
It's very simple. I care for you.
You enjoy making things complicated, don't you?
That's enough for now.
We shall speak again soon. I trust all is well.
I'd like to speak with you. In private.
Oh? How private?
There's a grove just outside of Skyhold. Meet me there.
If you're certain...
I am. Trust me.
On aching branch do blossoms grow, the wind a hallowed breath. It carries the scent of honeysuckle, sweet as the lover's kiss. It brings the promise of more tomorrows, of sighs and whispered bliss.
You can't be serious.
As I recall, your list was very specific.
And that is the poem you chose?
Oh, so the list is more detailed than I thought.
Carmenum de Amatus. I thought this one was banned. His lips on mine speak words not voiced, a prayer, which travels down my spine like flames that shatter night. His eyes reflect the heaven stars, the Maker's light. My body opens, filled and blessed, my spirit there.
Not merely housed in flesh, but brought to life.
Shall we read another?
They will say one of two things about me. That I stood at the Inquisitor's side, his protector and his lover. That it was meant to be. Or they will say I was led from the path of faith by the wiles of a madman.
I don't care what they say. What do you believe?
I believe you are the herald of Andraste, even if you do not. Beyond that, I believe only that you are capable of anything. And it frightens me. I have never known anything like it. I've been with only one other man in my life. A mage, with whom I adventured when I was still very young. He died at the Conclave. I will not let Corypheus win. I will not let him take you from me.
I love you.
Here, tonight, I believe you. You are quite distracting, you know.
I was hoping we could spend some time together.
What could we possibly do to pass the time? I can't believe you escaped before me. A fat count insisted on talking about soup for 15 minutes. We can return to Skyhold whenever you like. The sooner the better. Is something wrong?
I'm just worn out. Tonight has been very long.
It was a lot of foolishness. But we did strike a blow against Corypheus. We will need to put the soldiers at Skyhold on alert. Better to be safe.
Wait. There is one thing we must do before we go. May I have this dance, Lady Cassandra?
A dance? After all we've... Maybe if we'd found Hawk, the Maker wouldn't have needed to send you. But he did. You're not what I'd pictured. But if I've learned anything, it's that I know less than nothing. I can keep staring at this, but I won't get any closer.
Something I can help you with?
Yes. Possibly. We saw so many Red Templars at the assault on Haven. Perhaps all that was left of the Order. What we didn't see was Lord Seeker Lucius. Indeed, I've seen no hint of any Seekers amongst the Red Templars, or anywhere. I have a growing suspicion Corypheus has imprisoned them.
Why imprisoned? He could just as easily have killed them.
Not easily. But yes, they may be dead. But the Seekers began this war against the mages. They cannot have simply vanished. There must be a trail we can follow, yet so far I have only discovered hints.
But they could have ended up just like the Red Templars.
Seekers do not use lyrium. I assume Corypheus gained control of the Templars by corrupting the lyrium they were already taking. To do the same to a Seeker, you'd have to force the lyrium upon him. That may be what happened, but it couldn't have begun that way. We're missing a piece of the puzzle, Inquisitor. I need to find it.
Finding them obviously means a lot to you.
I left the Order, but I can never abandon them. I cannot even claim that rescuing them would be beneficial. They wouldn't look kindly on the Inquisition. But even so, if there's a chance... If we can spare resources to follow up on these leads, Inquisitor, I would appreciate it. Kaer Oswin. Odd that the trail should lead us here. Ban Loren is a pious, unassuming man. What has he become involved in?
He's involved in crazy. Just like everyone else these days.
Truer words have never been spoken. Let's see what lies within. Promises. I should have known. The Order of Fiery Promise is a cult with strange beliefs about the Seekers. They've hounded us for centuries.
What kind of strange beliefs?
They believe they are Seekers, the only rightful ones. They say we robbed their powers long ago, preventing them from ending the world.
Ending the world?
The only way to truly eradicate evil in their eyes. The world will be reborn a paradise. It's all nonsense.
Why haven't the Seekers dealt with them?
We have, many times. They simply reappear after a time like weeds. Nobody knows how.
Cultists? Why am I not surprised?
This explains why the Seekers might be here, but not the connection to Corypheus. As the Seekers of Truth have proven resistant to the effects of Red Lyrium, the Elder One has seen fit to place them in your care. Reclaim your destiny, and know that the Elder One expects your devotion as repayment. Signed by Lord Samson, Commander of the Red Templars. Does Corypheus not realize the promises want the world to end? What use are they to him?
So Corypheus sold the Seekers to these cultists?
And they leapt at the chance, of course. But this doesn't explain how he captured the Seekers in the first place, or what's been done with them. We must keep looking.
The letter said Seekers were resistant to Red Lyrium.
Our abilities grant us many gifts, but a resistance to Red Lyrium's corruption? That seems strange. Although it would explain why none have numbered among the Red Templars. And thus Seekers would be useless to Corypheus. He would have no leash to hold us.
We'll find them, Cassandra.
I know we will. One way or another. Daniel! Daniel! Can you hear me?
Cassandra! It is you. You're alive.
As are you. I'm so glad I found you.
No, they... put a demon inside me. It's tearing me up.
What? You can't be possessed. That's impossible.
I'm not possessed. They fed me things. I can feel it growing.
Can we do anything?
I don't know. This thing inside him.
The Lord Seeker. You have to find him.
Of course we'll find him. If he lives, we'll...
Lucius betrayed us, Cassandra. He sent us here, one by one. An important mission, he said. Lies! He was here with them all along. He's still working with them.
But we met Lord Seeker Lucius in Valroyo. He couldn't have been here.
That wasn't him. It was a demon, masquerading.
What? How could that be?
The Lord Seeker allowed it. He let the demon take command while he...
came here.
Cassandra.
Now is not the time for sympathy.
Wait. Don't leave me like this, please.
You should have come with me. You didn't believe in the war any more than I did.
You know me. I wanted that promotion.
Go to the Maker's side, Daniel. You will be welcome. He was my apprentice. I have never known a finer young man. Now we find Lord Seeker Lucius. Lord Seeker Lucius.
Cassandra, with a man I can only assume is the new Inquisitor.
And you're the man who betrayed his own order.
I presume you know we Seekers of Truth were once the original Inquisition. Oh, yes. We fought to restore order in a time of madness long ago, as you do now. And we became proud. We sought to remake the world, to make it better. But what did we create? The Chantry, the Circles of Magi, a war that will see no end.
And aiding Corypheus is supposed to help.
Corypheus is a monster with limited ambition.
And your ambition is so much greater.
We Seekers are abominations, Cassandra. We created a decaying world and fought to preserve it even as it crumbled. We had to be stopped. You don't believe me? See for yourself. The secrets of our order passed to me after the former Lord Seeker was slain. The war with the mages had already begun, but it was not too late for me to do the right thing.
He's completely mad, isn't he?
Lord Seeker, what you've done...
I know. What Corypheus did with the Templars does not matter. I have seen the future. I have created a new order to replace the old. The world will end so we can start anew. A pure beginning. Join us, Cassandra. It is the Maker's will.
He was insane. He had to be. The influence of Corypheus, perhaps? Was he trying to disable the Seekers?
All these wasted lives.
He could not have destroyed all of us. I won't accept it. Let us return to Skyhold. I wish to see what's in this Book of Secrets. This tome has passed from Lord Seeker to Lord Seeker since the time of the old Inquisition. And now it falls to me.
That's a lot of not very exciting reading, apparently.
On the contrary, it's a delight. I'm riveted.
Oh, you're joking.
I assume you know about the Rite of Tranquility. The last resort used on mages in the Circle, leaving them unable to cast, but depriving them of dreams and all emotion. It should only be used on those who cannot control their abilities, but that has not always been the case.
Does the book say it was used for other things?
No. As a Seeker, I looked into abuses. Mages made tranquil as punishment. What finally began the Mage Rebellion was the discovery the Rite of Tranquility could be reversed. The Lord Seeker at the time covered it up, harshly. There were deaths.